Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let me tell you about email spoofing. So did you ever get a piece of junk mail and it appears to come from you or from a friend of yours? Or perhaps you got a message from a friend of yours saying, hey, I got a piece of spam and it looks like you sent it. Maybe your computer's infected. Maybe your email account's been compromised. Well, when you get a piece of email that's coming from somebody different than actually who sent it, it's called email spoofing. And it's incredibly easy to do. So easy to do that any spammer is going to actually spoof their email addresses. They're never going to use their real email address when they send out spam. And very often they're going to use a real email address from somebody else, maybe somebody you even know, just to get you to open the email. So a false assumption many people have is that when you get a piece of email, it says it's from somebody and you think that has to be true. It has to be from that person. Well, that's not true at all. You can fake that very easily. Matter of fact, it's just as easy to do it in email as it is to do with physical mail. Physical mail, you put the return address here and it's supposed to be who this is from. But you can write anything you want here. Nobody's going to check that. You could put the President of the United States, the Queen of England, anybody you want here. And it's just as easy to do that in a piece of email. Matter of fact, for spammers, the software they use to send stuff out, that's going to allow them to put anything they want in there. They don't even have to have any technical know-how to do it. So you can't trust the from address in any email that you get. Most of the time it's going to be right because somebody who sends you legitimate email is going to want that from to be something accurate because they're communicating with you. But spammers don't care about that. Now let me show you how they can actually get your email address without even compromising your computer at all and make it look like you're sending out spam. So let's look at one way that this could happen. Here we've got Joe and Joe's computer. And Joe has some friends that he emails. So you can see here, these are Joe's friends and this is a list of all their email addresses. And these aren't necessarily in Joe's contacts. These are just, if you look at Joe's email, you'll find these email addresses in the from fields from all of the emails he's ever gotten. In addition to that, Joe also has all of his work people and he emails them and he has their email addresses on his computer. If you look through his email, all those email addresses are there. And also you've got Joe's special interest group. This could be Joe's neighborhood mailing list. This could be a hobby he's got and he's subscribed to this mailing list and he communicates with people. Or maybe his college buddies and they all email back and forth all the time things about their alma mater. So Joe's got a lot of different email addresses if you search through his email here. And they all combine to create all of this data here that's email addresses on Joe's computer. And when put together, they're Joe's email data. And it's all sitting there on his computer. So what happens if Joe gets his computer infected? Say he is using an old PC and it's out of date and he downloads something he shouldn't and now his machine's infected and he may not even know it. So what's going to happen now is that infection, that malware, is going to go and look at all of his email data and it's going to harvest it. And that may be it for Joe's computer. It may actually harvest all that data and send it somewhere else and Joe's computer doesn't actually do anything from that point on. Or Joe's computer can continue to be maybe the agent that sends out spam. So what happens when it sends out spam? Well, it's going to take an email address from Joe's email data, say this one, just at random. And then it's going to take another one, say this one. And it's going to compose an email. And that email could have anything in the from and to field. So what it's going to do is it's going to take this orange email address and it's going to stick it there in the from field. And it's going to take this purple one and it's going to stick it there in the to field. So now you've got an email that could be sent by Joe's computer. It could be sent by another computer somewhere else or a server in another country. It doesn't really matter. It's going to go and make it look like the email is from this orange person to this purple person here. And it's going to be spam. And what are the chances that this purple person knows this orange person? Well, actually pretty decent since they both know Joe. And if you look at all the possible combinations of sending from, say, this person to this person, or this person to this person, or two people over here, two people over here, it's going to send out a whole bunch of email, and a lot of those are going to recognize where it comes from. They're going to think it comes from somebody they know, and thus they're going to be that much more likely to read the email, which is all the spammer wants. The spammer may be sending out a million emails on a given day, and maybe 100 people read them. And if by doing this technique they can trick 200 people into reading them, well, they could perhaps double their return on whatever it is they're sending out. So that's why they do this. And the spammer doesn't care that this person here in orange is going to get an email from maybe this person in purple saying, hey, I think your computer's infected, or I think your email account's been compromised because I just got an email from you. Well, it turns out the orange person, their email account isn't compromised. Their computer doesn't have any malware. Their email address was just spoofed. They didn't do anything wrong. There's nothing for them to do. There's nothing they can do. And if a whole bunch of emails going to go out from this orange person to all of these people, there's nothing they can do but wait, field a bunch of emails from people saying, hey, I think you've been compromised, and kind of say, well, no, I think my email address has just been spoofed, and wait for it all to die down. The spammer doesn't care that that's going on. The spammer just cares that maybe a few more people clicked on the links in the body of the email, and that makes it all worth it to them, even though it's an annoyance to the person in orange. It's of course an annoyance to the person in purple. Joe may not even know it's going on, and that's all just collateral damage in the spammer's attempt to make money. So what do you do if you get a message from a friend saying that they got spam that appears to come from you? Well, despite everything I just said, you should still look at it as an opportunity to change your email password. This probably has nothing to do with you or your email account or your computer, but you should be changing your email password every once in a while anyway. And you should be changing it to something that's always a very strong random password. So look at this as an opportunity to do that. And while you're there, check things over just to make sure that everything looks legit. Look at your sent email, make sure that it's just stuff that you've sent, and it probably is. And then once you've assured yourself that everything looks okay and you've changed your password, then there's nothing to do but wait it out. Usually these kind of things happen for a day or two. Maybe your email address gets used a lot, and since there's nothing you do to stop it, you just kind of got to wait till you get through the wave of people responding to you or people notifying you about using your email address, and then it should all die down because the spammers are going to want to move on to another email address just to keep things going and keep the chances that somebody will open up a spam email a little bit higher. And so it's in their interest to actually move on after a little bit than to keep using your email address. So I hope this has been of help in explaining why it may look like spam is being sent out from your account even though it's not.